Hello guys, I have here this micro camera which is not really working as expected, and I'm looking for replacement. You can see here that this is the micro camera 1S, and we have here three additional wires. This one is smart audio. This is, and those two are the video in and video out. I could buy the same camera or any other which is compatible with it, but the thing is that I have few of those cameras and I really would like to try them, see how they work. And as you can see, there are quite some differences. The good thing is that this one is as well an N1S camera, and the only missing thing is those three additional wires from here. I could live without a smart audio. I don't really use it, to be honest, but I would really like to have the OSD. So what we can do? If you look on the YouTube, there are some videos which are telling you that you have to cut one of those wires from here or from here, and they refer to a specific model. Like they say, for this particular camera, cut this one out and you'll get the OSD. But I want to show you a really easy way to find which pin should you cut. And to be clear here is that if you see of on such kind of micro cameras, we have actually here two parts, two modules. This one is the camera model itself, and the other one where you have the channel switch and the antenna is actually the video transmitter. And of course, between the camera model and the video transmitter, there is a link for the video out from the camera to the video transmitter. And we need to find which one is that, and we need to cut to remove it so that we can solder two additional wires like in this model. So one will be video out from the camera, which needs to go into the flight controller, and from the flight controller the video out will go into transmitter. As I said, there is actually a quite simple method to find out, and for that you will need a multimeter. You just need to use the resistance to measure the resistance, and the method is that you put the negative lead on the ground, let's say here, and with the positive you need to find which pin. In this particular case we have five candidates to look for, and keeping the negative lead on the negative wire, you need to find which one with the positive lead, which one shows you about 170 ohms resistance, and most probable that's the jumper you have to cut. So let's see in this case what we have. So first pin is about its kilo ohms, so is not it. The second one is the ground itself, because we have about 0 ohms. The other one is again ground, because you have 0 ohms. So next one is about 20 kilo ohms, and the last one is 172 ohms. So basically we found the jumper, and the next move is to remove it. The easiest way to do that is, at least what I do, is to cut with a knife, to cut through this plastic and cut the jumper itself. It's pretty easy to do that. The only concern here is not to accidentally remove all those small components. Otherwise you won't put them back. So after cutting this jumper using soldering iron, you can easily remove one half and another half, and instead of this jumper you just need to solder two wires, one from here and one from here. The one from the camera model is video in the flight controller, and the other one is video out from the flight controller. Okay, let's try the same method on this camera. You can see here three wires coming from the camera model. So one would be the ground, the other one will be VCC, and the third one will be the video cable. So trying the first one, and we have like 100s of kilo ohms. The second one is the ground, and the last one is about 83 ohms. Yeah, 83 ohms. So in this particular case, this one is the video . Now let's try this one, a different model. So let's apply the same method. Kilo ohms. Next one. Hundreds of kilo ohms as well. Hundreds of kilo ohms. hundreds of kilo ohms. 160 kilo ohms. So we couldn't find the ground here. So something is not right with this camera. Probably there are some diodes or something, but it's not a problem because we can use the ground from here, because this part of the antenna definitely is connected to the ground. So let's use it as a ground. Now, if you try this pin, we get kilo ohms. This one, zero ohms, so that's the ground. Okay, it seems like we are on good track. Kilo ohms, kilo ohms. And the last one is 70 ohms. So in this case, this jumper is the video for sure. So to sum up, just check the resistance of every pin to the ground, if you can use the battery ground good. And if you don't get a result with the battery ground, then you can safely take the antenna ground, this one in this case, and check every pin. When you get to a pin with 75 to 175 ohms, then that's the pin that you can cut, and that's the pin which is the video jumper. So that's all for today. Bye bye.